Wake up, Hong Kong. The Spirit of God is with you. Not only His Spirit, but also His Word. It's midday. It's the moment to boost your mind and reset your time. Reset your spirit. Maybe you have gone off and you had a very rough morning. You had some difficulties getting started. Perhaps you got, you know, a few phone calls, text messages that really put you down. Well, this very moment, we're going to be offering a prayer for your family. But as we promise, we will blow the trumpet every midday as we will study the book of Gideon and the 300. So let's get started today and let's read here one of the pages in this brand new book that we are currently reading here from Monday to Friday, midday. And of course, if you want to get one of the copies of the book, you can walk into the help center here in Hong Kong, in China, Greater China, and get your copy and start feeding your minds with a positive spirit. So I'm reading today from page 29. You can open your book there at home, page 29. The fact that Gideon was threshing wheat in a wine press was a clear sign of the prevailing desperation of those days. A wine press was not the place to thresh wheat. It was meant for pressing grapes. Every vineyard in ancient times had its own wine press, which usually consisted of a 3 square meter tank cut in the rock. To thresh or separate the wheat from the chaff required a spacious threshing floor on a hilltop, with enough space to take in large volumes of grain. For this reason, a wine press was totally inappropriate and too small to thresh wheat. Threshing wheat in a wine press meant, number one, first, the quantity of wheat was very small. Second, the work was being done secretly, since a worker in a wine press was not visible, exposed as one on the threshing floor. Third, the humiliation was obvious, since only a completely desperate person would use a wine press for a threshing floor. Fourth, to thresh wheat in a wine press meant extreme needs. And fifth, the angel of the Lord did not appear to those who were hiding in the caves and dens. Rather, he appeared to the one who was risking his entire life for a handful of wheat. So, threshing wheat in a wine press would be the modern day equivalent of doing extremely hard work for less than minimum wage. In short, threshing wheat in a wine press means shame, fear, humiliation, need, and despair. Very well. So here we are reading and we're getting a better understanding of Gideon. Threshing wheat in a wine press, working very hard for very little results. And how many people today, they work much, but they get so little in return. They put so much effort, so much sacrifice, but they are sacrificing in the wrong way, in the wrong place, on the wrong altar. And because of that, the result is little to hardly anything. You know, what was important though, and that's what I really want you to get today for us to conclude our midday prayer and study. Though Gideon, he was getting very little result and making a lot of effort, the little he did, God was pleased with him because he was the only one taking an action. Everybody had given up. Everybody was in a cave, resting, afraid. He was the only person that had enough of it. He got out of the cave, left the comfort zone, and he did something. It's better to do something than to do absolutely nothing. So, though Gideon, he couldn't achieve what he wanted to achieve because he was doing everything alone. But God found in him a person that was willing to take action. All that Gideon needed was, you know, a little bit of direction. And that's why the angel appeared to Gideon. The angel did not appear to his father. The angel did not appear to his brother. The angel did not appear to his neighbor. The angel appeared to Gideon because Gideon was outside working. And that's exactly what God is asking us. Because change happens when there is an action. There must be movement. Change happens when people leave their comfort zone. And change doesn't happen just by prayer, because all of them were praying in the cave. But the moment when there is an action, so the eyes of God, the hands of God, they speedily move towards the person taking an action. You can be young, old, educated, uneducated, rich or poor, doesn't matter who you are. The moment you present faith in action before God, the Lord will hear, he will see, he will come down, and he will answer you. He will show you the way. He will tell you what to do. And he will even help you to find his altar. Because Gideon, he didn't know the altar of God. But when God showed him the way and he obeyed, that's when he blew the trumpet and he changed the story of his life. Yes, everything was to do with taking actions. Small actions, bigger actions, but nothing without actions. Gideon was a man of action, and God, he respects and he loves people that are of action. And that's our message for today. So no matter where you are, what you're doing, no matter your situation, if you see little results, no matter if you're facing shame, humiliation, if you are in despair, you know, if you're suffering injustice, if you are willing to take an action, so God is going to work together with you. He will show you the way, and you're going to change the story of your life. Of course, you have to do that together with God, not on your own. You have to do that in God's way. Yes, in God's court, that means to say, not your way, not on your ground, but God's ground is the altar of God. All right, so we're going to get ready right now for our prayer for the family. We're going to blow the trumpet, and right now, close your eyes. Join us in this prayer in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, right now at midday, we blow the trumpet. We blow the trumpet because we don't want to hear negative news. We don't want to hear lies or defeats. We don't want to listen to the injustice, the betrayal, words of the devil, the voice of the devil. But we want to go to war. We want you to show us the way of God to combat our emotions, to combat our weaknesses, to combat the addictions, to combat the divorce, the separation, the marriage problems, the difficulties in the family, the challenges with the children, the misunderstanding with the parents. We are here to combat the spiritual warfare. We are asking you now for you to move your power and your faith, yes, towards God. Oh, my Lord, you are watching Gideon. All alone, he was working there, trying to make a difference. But you were pleased with him, and you came into the picture, and you helped him, and you delivered him, and you gave him strength, and you healed him, and you gave him courage, and you were with him in the battle, and he blew the trumpet, and you made his enemies be defeated before his own eyes. Oh, my Lord, come and bring victory to this family. Bring restoration to this home. Bring healing to this person that has been chronically ill, going to the doctor. Yes, this person that has been depending on medication. This person that has been praying for the restoration of the marriage. This person that has been praying for the salvation of the children. This person that lost their job, that they don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. Right now, they're in a financial crisis and they need a miracle. They need an extraordinary answer. Oh, my Father, as we are blowing the trumpet at midday, reset everything, my Lord, and help this person make a new beginning. Oh, my Father, we bless everybody connected in the midday prayer, in the midday study, so that from this place, to everybody connected to us, there may be power, there may be energy, there may be revival, and there is protection upon you, upon your home, and no plague will come near those that serve God. No plague will come near your workplace. No plague will come near your family. And if you receive this blessing, say amen. Very well. So right now we have blown the trumpet. You are blessed. And now remember, if you want to join us in this special movement of faith, it's called the Campaign of Israel in the Valley of Gideon. So continue reading with us from Monday to Friday, our Bible study, and join us in prayer. For more information, send us a message via Facebook, a private inbox message, or walk into one of our centers. And remember that if you would like to help us and support the work of God, you can use here below the information to send your support. If you're in lockdown, we're praying for you, and make sure that when you get your holiday, you can join us in one of the meetings. We're open 7 days a week. You can connect with us here live in the meetings in the sanctuary. All right. May all of you have a wonderful day and keep feeding your mind with the Word of God. We'll be back again tomorrow. God bless you.
How to send your donation to support the House of God. How to use the machine. Step 1. You can access the machine without a card by pressing the Enter button. Step 2. Enter the account number of the UCKG Help Center here in Hong Kong. The account number is 74705777601. The account name is the Incorporated Trustees of the Universal Church of the Kingdom of God. And the bank name is HSBC.